tonight for our benefit performance of Sound of Music with a Twist, which means we've added a few things to it. The show was already 4.5 hours long, so we decided to add a few more songs. So you should be out of here by close to 1 a.m., and then there'll be a lovely reception for you. So we cut a lot of it and added a few things that make it a little special. So we're really excited to have you here tonight. As most of you know, the reason we put on a musical every summer is to support our foundation that helps homeless and disadvantaged kids with childcare here at CCC. This summer, we have 23 kids enrolled in school that would not be here without the help of this foundation. So your presence here tonight, especially tonight when the tickets are kind of exorbitant for a children's musical, means a lot, because that really supports what we do here. We wouldn't be able to have these kids, we wouldn't be able to have them participate in this program without your help. So I thank you very much, because this program and those kids mean a lot to me. So your being here makes a difference in so many lives, and I can't thank you enough for that. This is our 21st summer of doing music experiences. We had a massive flood here on January 7th of this year. The whole school was flooded and destroyed, pretty much. Down to the drywall was ripped out, the floors ripped out, the bathrooms, the kitchen, our beloved stage. The whole school was gutted, and we had to rebuild and come back. So tonight, we are doubly excited to have you here, because we were able to rebuild our school with the support of so many people in the community that came and made a difference and made it happen. So tonight, not only are we celebrating our 21st year, we're celebrating our new stage, we're celebrating the difference we make in the lives of so many kids because of your participation and your support. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'll see you outside after the show on our lovely deck for a beautiful reception. It's going to be just wonderful. Have a ball. I'll see you later.
Hail Mary. do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she always seems to be getting into trouble, doesn't she?
She climbs a tree and scrapes her knee, her dress says rather tear. She waltzes is on the way to mass and whistles on the stair. And underneath her whipple she has curlers in her hair. I've even heard her singing in the Abbey. She's always late for chapel, but her penitence is real. She's always late for everything except for every meal.
Thank you.
supposed to stay until September.
Will you be at home for your dad instead?
Just until tomorrow. The telephone, was it for me?
No, it was for Franz. It was before he arrived, he was calling to get a Franz ring. I have the number in the pantry.
I know the number. Oh, I shall be back in about a month with some guests.
Do you know how many is there?
Just two, Herr Duttweiler.
Herr Duttweiler.
And Frau Schrager.
Who wanted me on the telephone?
It was the post office. They got a telegram to you. You know Brain Boy will be delivering it.
I'm Captain Bontrap and you are Fraulein.
Marie, Reary.
Now, Fraulein, as your duties here, before you meet the children, you will put on another dress.
I haven't any other dress. When we enter the Abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
What about this one?
The poor didn't want this one.
This is what you call a worldly dress?
It belonged to our last postulant. If I had been given time, I would have made more. I can make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you are given some material today, if possible. Now you will be in charge of my children. There are 9 of them. Each morning will be spent in class and each afternoon they march. You will see that all times they conduct themselves with decorum and orderliness. The first rule of this house is discipline.
Always tell father to mind his own business.
Louisa, don't. Well, now I know where to start. I'm going to teach you to sing.
The first three notes just happen to be.
Rick, Louisa, Brigitte, Marta, Kurt, and little ones, Leon, Rosemary, and Johan. Oh, yes, and the other boy. What's his name? Well, God bless what's his name. And now, about Liesel.
Are you going to tell on me?
Help her know that I'm her friend, and help me to be understanding so that I may guide her footsteps.
I was out taking a walk, and somebody locked the doors earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake up again. You're not going to tell Father, are you?
Were you out walking all by yourself? You know, if we wash that dress out tonight, no one will notice in the morning. It would just be between you and me. Here, you can put this on. Then take your dress in the bathroom and put it to soak in the bathtub.
Earlier today, I told you I didn't need the governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh. better now that I see you here. You know, you're a little like those mountains. Except, you keep moving. How can you stay away from this place as much as you are?
Maybe I'm searching for a new reason to come back, to stay.
Here, I like it here very much.
Max can't still be on the telephone. I know he's desperate for singers for the Carlsberg Festival, but you like it here?
Oh, yes. We have spent some time in Vienna. I have an estate to look after.
I thought it was a corporation.
It is. I'm president.
You president of a corporation?
Yes, I made it to Mr. Zafir's years before he passed.
I just can't see you behind the desk.
Well, of course, whoever visits didn't smoke a big cigar.
Sorry, it took so long.
How would you like this for the Carlsberg Festival? The finest choral group with the greatest mixed soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. All I've got up to now is a basso, who isn't even profundo.
Max, what's up with your festival concert?
We'll see. I've been telephoned from Paris, Rome, Stockholm.
How do you telephone?
How else could I afford it?
I hope it's because you like me.
Of course I like you. Why shouldn't I like you? You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official, Derek, are there any cathedrals around here?
There's a rabbi, Nuremberg Abbey.
Good. In the next few days, I shall visit all these towns, listen to choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Of course I will.
I can't understand where the children have gone.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to greet you.
Well, it couldn't have been intentional, like, because they haven't met me yet.
Forgive me. I'll try to find them.
Elsa, have you made up Garrett's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes.
He hasn't admitted it yet. I should see something standing in his way.
You don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich and you're rich. In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle.
Rubbish.
I'm going to love seeing you with all 9 of the captain's children.
There's a little place called boarding school.
How are you going to convince Garrett to send all of his kids away?
I have my ways.
I'm a girl, and by me that's only grace. I am proud that my silhouette is curvy, that I walk with a sweet and girlish gait. With my hips kind of swivel.
left already. You brought music back into my home that I had forgotten.
Thank you.
ready to come and see me.
She doesn't speak. She hasn't spoken except in prayer.
I shall see her now.
Maria!
Maria! Why have they sent you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left without telling them I was going, without saying goodbye. I couldn't face him again.
Him? Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
I don't know.
But do you like him, Maria?
Yes.
My daughter, if you love this man, it doesn't mean that you love God any less. You must find out. You must go back. These walls were not made for you to shut out your problems. You have to face them head on. You have to find the life you were born to live.
Drop some roses and whiskers. boys, Maria, we'll be inside.
You've come back.
Yes.
You left without any explanation whatsoever, not even saying goodbye.
That was wrong. Please forgive me.
So you're back to stay?
Only until you can make arrangements for another governess.
Oh no, the children have missed you far too much. Everybody missed you.
I'm sure the bear has made this wonderful for you.
There's one thing you do better here than you do in Vienna. Your sunsets.
I'd like to miss them.
Pardon me, Captain. The children would like to know if they could take a holiday off their lessons this afternoon so we could go on a picnic.
Yes, I don't mind.
Thank you. That will make them very happy. And may I be permitted to congratulate you? The children have told me you are going to be married.
Thank you. But I'm afraid the children were wrong. I'm ready to get back to you, Vienna. I can't do this. You're in love with someone else. We'll never be enough. I'm going to say Georg.
Elsa, wait!
What's the matter, Polly? Aren't you still at your back?
Yes.
It doesn't seem like it.
Oh no, I'm fine. Captain is a hard man to meet at times, but it's not impossible.
He's getting married to the Baroness, and that's how it should be.
Don't be too sure.
What?
The Captain loves you, and you love him. That's the way it should be.
But
listen.
Thank you. am the head of the family.
I'll enjoy seeing you, Captain Ron Trapp, singing in concert. I'll be in front row watching every move you make.
The instruments that you see on the walls are available for purchase. It's a suggested donation of $10. All of the proceeds for tonight go into our scholarship fund, which helps these fantastic children. We will see you guys outside. Thanks so much.